still the still remember the formula that we use to find the gradient? Normally, we represent the gradient of a straight line by m. M is equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. When you are given the y-intercept and x-intercept, you also can use this formula. M is equal to negative y-intercept divided by x-intercept. In Form 2, you have learned about the four types of gradient. When the straight line is going upward, okay, let me draw a diagram first. Okay, let me draw a few diagrams first. When a straight line is going upward like this, the gradient is positive. When a straight line is going downward, the gradient is negative. When the straight line is going horizontally and parallel to the x-axis, the gradient is equal to zero. If the straight line is going upward vertically and parallel to the y-axis, the gradient is undefined. Now let's try how to find the gradient. You have a straight line. This is x. Okay, let's say you have 2 points here, which is 1, 3, and the point is over here, which is -1, -1. If we want to find the gradient of this red line, what type of formula should we use? This or this? When you look at this diagram, you will notice that we don't have the y-intercept and x-intercept, right? So we will choose to use we will choose this formula to help us to calculate the gradient. But before we calculate, we know the gradient must be positive. Why? Because this straight line is going upwards. Y2 minus y1. Always remember y on the top. 3 minus negative 1. 3 minus negative 1. Okay, remember if I take 3 minus negative 1 for the x part, I have to take 1 minus negative 1. Follow the sequence. 1 minus negative 1. So this is 3 plus 1. 1 plus 1. Right? Negative, negative become positive. So here you will get 4 and you will get 2 here. The gradient is 2. So let's say if you don't want to take 3 minus negative 1, you can go another way. Gradient is equal to, okay, now I take negative 1 minus 3. Remember, y on the top. Negative 1 minus 3. If I take negative 1 minus 3, for the x part, I have to take negative 1 minus 1. Follow the sequence. On the top here, you will get negative 4. And this, you will get negative 2. Negative 4 divided by negative 2, this negative will actually cancel up. 4 divided by 2, you get 2. You see, you will still get the same answer. Let's try this one. Y, x. The y-intercept is 4. And the x-intercept is 2. Find the gradient. So now, we have the x-intercept here and the y-intercept. We can use this formula. Before we find the gradient, we know the gradient must be negative. Why? Because this straight line is going downward. Remember, if you use this formula, put a negative. Y-intercept, which is 4, here. X-intercept, which is 2. Okay, so you get negative 2. If you don't want to use this formula, you want to use this formula, you still can get the same answer. When you use this formula, you need a full coordinate. Okay, what is the coordinate for this point? On y-axis, x is 0, 0. and this is 4. How about this? On x-axis, y is equal to 0, and this is 2. Okay, let's try. Use another formula to find the gradient of this straight line. y2 minus y1. Remember, y on the top. 4 minus 0. If I take 4 minus 0 for the x part here, I have to follow the sequence 0 minus 2. It's 4, this is negative 2. You still get the same answer, negative 2.